Hi. 2 years ago, her car engine belt started squealing continuously. On that occasion, I decided I better go watch some YouTube videos and find out what alternative procedures they have to deal with the problem. Some videos mention replacing pulleys, some mention replacing the belt, and one of them talked about taking the belt out and cleaning it. And that one struck my attention because on previous occasion I had purchased spray cans to spray on the belt, and those things didn't work long, in a week or two. So what I did, if you can, I concluded that I can as well clean my belt. But instead of taking it out, I decided to dry clean the belt and without taking it out. So that's what this video is about. So the next day, I was excited. I said, oh, great. I got rid of that awful sound. And then I got wiser. I said, well, I better wait a couple of days. And that turned into a couple of weeks, months. Then I forgot about it. And today, it's 2 years later. 2 years later, I heard a little squeal and I say, I have to make that video, okay? So if that can work for 2 years for me, maybe that will be good enough for you as well. All done, thank you. I'll be back. This is the type of belt that I have, with lots of grooves in between. And what I actually used was a piece of foam, taking a thick cushion, discarded. You'll find foam in it. So I took a piece of foam like that, and I held the foam with these long tweezers or long nose pliers. But this is very long, as you can see, longer than my hand plus some. So I'm holding on to the handle. And I found a location where the belt was going away from the pulley, because I didn't want the belt to pull the foam and trap the foam under the pulley, therefore pull the long nose pliers and eventually pull my arm. So before I continue, I must warn you, if you have never been on top of a running engine and that's your first time, just don't try it. Especially if you have a tie in your neck or a scarf that can go down and pull the rest down towards trouble. So don't even try that, all right? Now, I held this like this and the belt was going away from the pulley, so I pushed the foam against the belt, and the friction force kept cleaning the belt. And I stayed there, let's say, for 10 minutes and maybe repeated the same thing for another 10 minutes. I wasn't sure I was doing good enough a job, but as you're going to see, as the belt is rotating and while I keep the foam on it, when I finally pulled away the belt and I saw these marks on it, and I say, oh well, I'm doing something. So today I'm telling you about it because it lasted for 2 years. I was able to dry clean the belt just like that. It wasn't comfortable finding a position where the belt was moving away from a pulley. You know how the belts go. They go from one pulley to the other, or drive shaft. So you have to find yourself at a location where you can apply pressure with the foam on the belt, and at the same time, you don't want to hold on too tight to these pliers. If the bell grabs the foam, you should release the pliers so they fall on the ground instead of having the pliers follow the foam, then your hand following the pliers like that. You don't want that. But while the engine is running and you don't have a tie around your neck and you don't have scarf around your neck and you're familiar with engine, you can dry clean your belt. And if you are as lucky as I am, the sound will go away, the squealing will go away for a couple of years. So this is what this video is about. It's about dry cleaning your engine belt. Thank you. You should do that before you spend any money. All right, good luck. Bye-bye. I came back to tell you that I'm sure that you can use a foam paintbrush. I included the pliers there, and you can use it at different angles, but make sure you don't hold on to the pliers too tight. I don't know if the foam paintbrush will allow you to apply the right amount of pressure, but you can always try that. Anything that breaks away, let it go. Don't follow it.